Hi everyone, welcome back in my channel today. Hope you all are doing safe and good at your place. Today I come up with a new topic, ServiceNow Cubic Lost and Found New Features and the Applications. In this video, we will mainly discuss on the new features and the application which has been introduced by ServiceNow in Cubic release. So let's not put more time on the introduction part and go to the next slide. So till now, ServiceNow has released multiple versions starting from Aspen, Berlin, Calgary, and before Aspen as well, they have summer, winters as well. And from 2011, they started with a specific way of new versions. In Cubic has been released in March 2021. I know Cubic has been released in the time period when we are all facing a pandemic across the world, COVID-19. And being a company, ServiceNow come up with the solutions for the same as well. So let me pick up the new features which has been added by ServiceNow in the Cubic release. In this video, I will try to give you a little practical exposure as well for some of the new options. Number one, on the top, Safe Workplace Suite has been introduced by ServiceNow for the COVID-19 apps. So this app includes basically, if I go to the next slide, so this particular suite includes the Employee Readiness Survey, Employee Health Scanning, Workplace Safety Management, PPE Inventory Management, Safe Workplace Dashboard, Contact Tracing, Employee Readiness Score, and health safety testing. Mainly via these six or seven applications, ServiceNow give me an end-to-end tracking of the COVID-19 stuff which is be required on the workplace, which is be required in any of the organization. How I can forget that ServiceNow give us another module or the another application called the vaccination status as well. Just to do, you need to be install this, or you need to be activate the Safe Workplace Suite in your instance, production, some non-production instance, and then you can proceed with this application uses. Now the second point basically, or the second feature which has been introduced by ServiceNow, is called the Auto Assignment. It look like very small, but let me show you on the practical example here. So what ServiceNow give basically here, let me create one incident. Click on the create new, and what I will do, I'll put one caller here. Let me put Tanmay, and let me put a configuration item, network, or let do one thing, let me move to my scoping part as well, global, and let me impersonate with my own ID. Let's not go with the admin part. Yep. So now I will log in with my user, learn and grow. There's a no difference which I'm doing here. Just I, to be comfortable, I use my own user ID, even though that user also have a same access. Create new. Able tutor. Let me put configuration, application, server, PeopleSoft, test, auto assignment. And let me click on the save here. When I click on the save, you will notice that assignment will be auto-populated. You can see here, this has been auto-populated. So how this has been come automatically, this has been coming from the option that your configuration item should contain, let me open this, should contain the support group in the data, in the CMDB data, you can see here. If it is not available, then it will not auto-populate the assignment group. So In few of the cases, when I know that, okay, this application, this CI has been supported by this particular group, so better I put that group into the CMDB, and that will resolve a lot of auto assignment problems as well. So this was the first feature. Second feature which we discussed just now is called the auto assignment. For a quick win, you can tell to your customer which is be a good place for the auto assignment. The third one which we are here is called the change model. Yes. So this is a newly one introduced by ServiceNow in the Cubic release. The major or the good point which I like, if you go here and click on the create new, ServiceNow changed the complete interpreter for the change module now. Let it be load completely. I'll show that part. So you can see earlier we have three options. Like we have three options like a normal change, emergency change and the standard change. So now ServiceNow changed the complete interpreter and give a good feel, a good user interface for the users to select that part. So in this you can say, if you are going to pin up, suppose I pinned some models, you can use it here. Emergency and the normal change, you have to pin up. Pre-approved means all the pre-approved standard changes, and if you click here all, this is the complete list, you will get it here. Now the question comes, Atul, what do you mean by the model specifically here? Let's take an example that I am raising a normal change, but my change is a model of the network category. Maybe I can say I want to define something on the category part, or I want to define something on the different change models, network model, unauthorized model, patching model. So you can define those models easily at your end. If I click here on the normal change, ITL models, basically ITL mode, I can say. So you can see mod, you can see on the top it is available here. Okay, now if I remove this normal and I put double asterisk, I can still able to see these two. So how you can get this model on the change form? Number one, you have to be activate the plugin, that is change model plugin is there, you can activate that part and then go here and search for the model. I go here and go to the change admin, change models here. Let me click leave here. So now you can define your workflow on the basis of the model as well, irrespective of your type of the change. So you can see here change registration, change cloud infrastructure model, unauthorized changes model as well. So if I click here, so you can see they have given some condition, let it be load completely. So there's no, so they have condition that record preset is the emergency change, short description is this, change management, and they put this unauthorized is a true. So what we can do, let go here available in the create new, let click here and click on the save here and go to the change and click on the create new. So it has some, I can say that model is basically kind of a template which is already pre-built here. So you can see that I have a unauthorized change here. Click here and it will be load the value for you. Unauthorized change, emergency type, and you can say this thing has been coming automatically. So one thing which I can say, it is different than the category. Second part I can say, when you are working or supporting multiple customers or one customer in the multiple areas, cloud, infra, network, servers, in that case you can use the model specifically, that how many changes has been raised for the server as a model. Normal emergency, you can find that part, and you can see the state is directly moving to the review part here. Authorized or new review, it is available. So this is the third feature which has been introduced by ServiceNow in the Cubic release. You will be surprising that this has been configured in the Flow Designer. To run this particular flow, you have to use the Flow Designer, not in the workflow. They are using the Flow Designer for this specific thing now. On the next side, we are going for the NLP on the list view. Definitely, it's again quick win for the customer specifically. Let me go on the incident or the change, and incident, I click on the all. Now if I want to filter out my records from this particular list, I have many options. Number one, I can put the caller name here, I can put the priority here, I can put the state here, I can use the funnel icon as well here to build up my query. But definitely, Atul, if you're telling this, it means something new is given by ServiceNow, because ServiceNow always says, I'm working for the user experience perspective. And what they did, they introduced something called the NLP here. Just click on this and start typing your question here. Priority. Yep. Let me put impact. Impact is what I can say. Urgent. Ask. So you can get these things. Sorry, we cannot understand the query because maybe impact don't have a urgent. Let go here. Go back here and try to improve something. Okay, priority is high. Let's see if it finds some record for me. If not, yes, it finds some record for me, and you will not believe that it already built up some query for you. Now, on the top of that, short description contains test ask. So you can see all the short description which has a ask. Then I can put state is new. See, if I put the wrong query here, it will not understand. But still, it understands this new, it understands for me. So if you put the wrong spelling, it will not understand. But as a natural language, ServiceNow improving this and coming on the maturity perspective as well. So this is our fourth feature which has been introduced by ServiceNow, called the NLP list view specifically, which I showed you here. The next one which is introduced from the reporting part, and on the same place they use the NLP and the NLQ with the formatting. Let's go to the reporting part here. Report, and let me click a create new report. Okay, now being a user experience perspective, as I told in my slide as well, that ServiceNow give me the NLQ or NLP perspective, so you can get the same option here. Here only difference is that you have to be select the table as well first. Incident is, or incident priority is high. Intentionally I am putting the wrong spellings as well, that is it, will it be understand or no? No, it is not understanding because my report or my keywords are not correct. Let me put incident state is new. Let's see if it finds something for me or not. New. Yep, it is able to find for me here. So this is the one feature which has been introduced, called the NLQ or NLP on the reporting part. Instead of writing or go here, now you can see everything has been auto-populated from here. Data, it's pick up this thing, all the things is there. Type, it is pick up by default this. Now if I go here for the next part, that is I can show the decimal formatting. Let me go and make it as a score. And now click on the run. Because it cannot give me this one. Okay, now let me change it to the some other part. Go to the, okay, let go on the score. Okay, and let me create a new query here, or let's start a new query here. Type is this, configure. Okay, go to configure part here and set the value formatting. I said aggregation, give me the count here, because this count was missing, so it is not giving me the anything here. So it's a 138. Now suppose let me put an average. If I get something, run, 6 days 34 minutes 4 hours and 30 minutes. If I want to make a change in this format, I can go to the set value formatting and I can do the formatting here like this. Show original value in the tooltip. I can remove hide seconds part. I can remove that part and click on the run here. Sorry, seconds has been removed already. Let me put the business duration. I'm looking for something on the result, and let's take business resolve time and click on the new. Yeah, okay, so now you can see here 07. So let's go to the formatting part here. So you can do this thing, a decimal up to 4 you want to show, it can show you like this manner. Okay, rounding half up, you can do the round as well, up down floor, I can say half up. Okay, use a 1000 group separator. This is one of the beautiful things which has been introduced by ServiceNow. Enable abbreviation. Like this, you can see here. Now click here and go here. Because it is already showing the less one, so it is not be picking up that value here. Enable and this thing. Use 1000 separator and click on the. Sorry, I did not submit it. Submit it. And now it will load for me. So now you can see this has been replaced completely. So you can see here. So this is the another feature has been added by ServiceNow in the reporting perspective to show the data in the formatters and in the K's or M's or B's, you can put it here. The next one which has been introduced by ServiceNow called the universal request. I already created a video on the same as well. So universal request is basically, I can say, is a replacement of a feature called the new call, which is available till the Paris release. So what you can do here, you can go here universal request and you can create a new universal request. So in this case, what happened that when any customer, any end user is raising any record, it will be become as a universal request. You can create a catalog item for this and the portal, and the user will get only the universal request. In the background, you can create any incident, you can create any HR case. So to activate this, you need to be install or you need to activate the plugin called the universal request for the HR core, and the incident will become by default when you install this universal request. So let me show you here test and let me click on the save here. When I click on the save, I am getting an option assigned to me specifically because I did not install the plugin end to end as of now. Just to show you, I am creating this part. So you can see here that I am getting the primary ticket because I don't have that option available, which say it is a HR case or it is a incident. So the UI action will be available on the top and then you can follow the HR case, or as a, I can say, you can create an incident. The detailed description, the detail you will get in my another video, which is already in my playlist. You can go and check that part. Now the next one, that is called the UI builder. Every time my developer complained to me that making a changes on the portal, creating a new portal, creating a catalog items or UI pages is always a problematic for me. So to remove, to sort out that problem, ServiceNow introduced the new application called the UI builder. You can see here. You can see here. In the Now Experience workspace, I have the UI builder. I already opened this because it's taking little time to be loaded. So I already opened that, and you can see here that you can create your experience. You can create your Now platform things very easily. You can create your portals, and to create in that portals, you can create the templates as well easily on that part. So you can see here. You can just click on the create experience in the platform. It will open a new page for you, and where you can go and create your portals very easily. You can update corrections or you can anything, you can do it here. Just to ease the work of the developer on these parts, they introduce the UI portal available. So you can see all already built up portals are like this here. Now you can, if you want to make a change, you can do the changes in the UI portal easily. So this is the option available, I can say, or it is a good feature or the application has been introduced by ServiceNow to create your catalog specifically, or to create the or make a changes on the portal level. So you can do that part very easily. It is a new feature given by ServiceNow. Instance scan, a fantastic feature just to see the health of my instance specifically. So there's a no separate plugin required for this. You can go here and you can just put the instance scan. So you can see here, I have a multiple checks, suites, results, finding, dashboards available for me. I can just click on the checks here. So you can create your own check that where you want to run this. Basically, what instance scans do, it will go into my codes in, and identify the blockers, the time consuming things basically I can find out. So you can see here that I created my check on this by this way. Let me say script. All processors of the type, let me show you the type of the script, must be CRFS token specifically. So I can run it. I can run it and it will be work for me specifically. So instance scan, basically a good application or the feature has been introduced by ServiceNow from that architect perspective, from the development perspective. Then I go to the next one, that is called the business continuity management. Somehow I'm not able to install that into my Cubic or the PDI instance, but business continuity management, as the name indicates, this has been introduced by ServiceNow to capture or to make sure you are able to fight with your crises and you are able to map your ITs, your CIs, your services accordingly, and you can manage it if anything goes wrong in your organization. So you can plan everything on the business continuity management. Apologies that I cannot show you something on the portal or the instance as of now. Workforce optimization. Another good feature has been given by ServiceNow to monitor specifically the team perspective. I'll not say that it is a managerial perspective, but it is an option available in ServiceNow where you can monitor your team, that how much team is loaded or overloaded with the work. So what I did basically, and to activate that, to get this application, you have to be activate the plugin called the Workforce Optimization. Once you do that part, you will be getting the module available in the Navigator Workforce. So you can see I have the Workforce Optimization for the ITSM. This is only for the ITSM as of now, and you can see here multiple options are given. As I open the manager workspace, you can see it's take little time, so I already opened that part for my purpose. Not here, process. Yeah, okay. So this is the workspace available for the managers to monitor their team. So I have multiple options here. You can see the channels available. You can see your schedules available, basically shift approvals. You can see the team shifts here completely, that how many shifts are available. You can see the calendar of the teams as well, on off, all the things. You can manage your teams as well here, because I don't have any member here. Or let me just reload my page, because I impersonate and the impersonation and login with my ID. It takes little time to reload. That is how I was avoiding. Okay, now I am here. Okay, learn and grow. So as of now, there's a no team under me, so I'm not able to see that part. Then you can see other stuff, basically coaching. If any KPI you have assigned to your colleagues or assigned to your team members, you can track it here. So in short, workforce optimization specifically work from the team performance, team enhancements, skill enhancements, all the things you can be track it here. In short, we are moving out from the standard tools or the Excel sheets, and we're coming in the ServiceNow to see the team performance in day in, day out. The next one which is given by ServiceNow is a process optimization. This is one of the finest one, which I can say it is good. And this particular module is good for the process owners or the process manager. I'm not able to find out something for us, which I can demonstrate here, but this is the workspace available here. So what I can do, let me show you here quickly. Optimization. And let me show you here. I'm not in the workforce. I'm talking about the process optimization. So you can see here. In this, you need to be create your project specifically. Let me open the projects here. And this is the analyst workbench, which I'm going to be showing you. This is the analyst workbench. where what you can do, you can create your projects. When I talk about the project specifically, it basically means that you can define your projects on the table level. Suppose I want to know that how my different fields in the incident table. Let me pick up this example here. Okay, let do this thing. Filter out and show matching here. Okay, this one, yes, let me take this one, which is given by ServiceNow out of the box. So you can see I created one, it is be given by ServiceNow to me as out of the box. What they say, this template configure will be used when PI to be incident data. So what is basically doing, it gathering this data, category, business, service, assignment group, knowledge, priority and state. And on the basis of that, it will draw a pictorial picture for me where I can understand that how my process is working. Suppose whenever my service desk agent change the business service, they stuck for few minutes to see where I should go to the next level. So in this case, I can put it the work process optimization, a separate module available in the service now, which as a process manager, you can use that part. The next one, which is coming as a script tracer, basically. This is purely from the technical perspective, from the development perspective. What you can do, you can evaluate, you can check your scripts as well. So what I can do, script tracer, simple, sweet, short module available or given by ServiceNow, where you can track or start the tracer specifically. In this case, you have to be define that what type of file you want to do it, what type of script you want to see it. So what it will do basically, it will check your scripts, your syntax and all the things, and see how you can optimize that part specifically. So I can say my script runner is on as of now. If I run any script, I can find out that part. This is a script debugger where I can go and see what the script points I'm getting here. And this is my session logs, what I am checking at this point of time. So in short, this is available, or this is a good option given by ServiceNow to the development team to check the script, how the script is behaving or not. The next one which is coming is basically CSDM 3.0. This is a hot cake in the market as of now. A lot of companies are asking about this. In short, if I go to my next slide, you can see here. CSDM is a framework. It is not a tool. It is not a code, actually. It is just a framework which help you to establish your data in the right manner in ServiceNow. So when I say in ServiceNow, basically CSDM work on the CMD for the CMDB data as of now. And in Cubic release, they have introduced this new domain called the foundation as well. No, don't worry. I'm coming up with a new videos on the CSDM very soon, where you will get the complete idea that how the CSDM has been designed. But from the interview perspective, I can say you can go through these four domains, because this has been mainly asked in the interview. And sometimes it has been asked that what is the meaning of the dynamic CI group, which has been introduced in the CSDM 3.0. The next one, that is called the catalog variable. In this catalog variable, only one thing has been introduced by ServiceNow specifically. If I go here, let me close this and let me go here and search for the catalog variable. Yeah. Let me click on the all variables here, cross this, and I can new here. So on the catalog variable, ServiceNow introduced a new field which is called the hidden, actually. Means you can hide any variable as well by storing the value. So you can see here, this is the hidden option, has been introduced by ServiceNow. Two or three more functions you can use, or you can follow with this. But in our session, basically, we're talking about the hidden part, that you can make any field hidden as well, or as a read-only as well if required on the same part. Okay, but you can see that things are being moving in the separate manner. So this is the one thing which has been introduced by the ServiceNow in the Cubic release. Catalog data lookup rule, a fantastic one which has been introduced by ServiceNow. Let's take example. Before Paris release, what happened that if I am on my catalog page, I am taking a user record and I want that the manager should be populated automatically. To do that part, I need to be write the catalog scripts in the catalog UI policy. If I go here and catalog UI policies, if you go here, I need to be write the scripts so that I can get the user data or group data or location data. But to do that part, ServiceNow introduce the new feature called the catalog data lookup, where it will be work in the similar manner as we are working with the data lookup, like impact urgency we are using or the assignment rule we are using. But in this case, you have to create your matcher table, your setter table, setter fields, matcher field, and then you can utilize that part. Now I'm moving to the last feature which has been introduced by ServiceNow, is called the encoded query. This is the very beautiful, which I like actually. Maybe not a quick win, but it is a good for the service perspective. So let me go here on the incident. Let me let me go on the open. Okay. And let me put a filter here. Planning, show matching, and filter out. Okay, now I have these two things. Okay, what I want, or let me do a filtration like this. I don't want to open this actually. Okay, or let me like this. I want this one. Okay, I want to create a new incident with the same value. What you can do, click on the create new. What ServiceNow done in the background, it will pick up the same color, it will become the same category, and it will pick up the same priority as well, and will create an incident for you. So you can say this thing, and this thing. Sorry, it should not be no actually, right? But it's picking up this manner. Let me remove this and try something else here. Okay, let's click on the all here. Okay, let me go here on the show matching. And now click on the all the tickets are closed. Okay, let go here and put category as a network. Okay, and now I click on the category this way. So in this case, I did not select any color here. My previous example was working absolutely correct, that which you can use it basically. So this is called the encoded query in ServiceNow, which has been introduced by ServiceNow in the Cubic release specifically. So guys, this was from my side, approximately 12 to 15 new features has been introduced by ServiceNow, which I try to show you in one by one manner. If you like this video, please like and share with your friends, subscribe my channel, and always follow one motto, that is learn and grow together. Thank you so much guys, have a nice day, stay safe and stay at home. Bye bye. Thank you.